bless the Lord. Amen. We give honor to all of you on this morning. We honor our pastor, Pastor Newsom, on this morning, the Providence Church family. We bring you greetings, amen, from our pastor this morning. We thank you, each and every one of you. Hallelujah. We're sorry about being a little bit late. We've been busy this week. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. I'm going to go into the word of the Lord. Hallelujah. And we do have another service on this evening. So you may get a little sermonette. But I tell you, God is going to bless you on today. God is going to speak to you on today. If you set your cup out, if you set your heart out, if you set it out, God's going to fill you. God's going to give you some things that's going to help you navigate through this week. I guarantee you that the word of God, it shall go forth and accomplish all that he sent it out to do. Hallelujah. I'm just going to have a little word of prayer. Oh, Heavenly Father, oh God, we thank you, Lord. We thank you for an opportunity, God, that we are standing here, God. We are clothed in our right mind, God. We have the activities of our limb, God. Oh, God, we ask that you bless every hearer, God. Let not your word fall on deaf ears. Let it not fall on hardened hearts, God. Oh, God, but let your word minister, God, to the broken places, God. To the downtrodden, Father God. To the backslider, Father God. Oh, God, minister to those that are sick, those that are dealing with grief, God. We pray for words of comfort. We thank you for words of peace. We thank you that you would enlighten us on today, Father. Oh, God, have your way. And we take full authority, God, over every evil force, everything that's lurking. In the mighty name of Jesus, we plead the blood of Jesus over this service. We plead the blood over our pastor, over his family, over everyone under the sound of my voice. I decree and I declare that you're setting them free now, even while the word of prayer is going forth. God, we give you glory. We give you praise. Holy Spirit, I ask that I step out of the way. Hey. Hey, Oshata. And you have your way. You do what you do, God. And I give you all of the glory. I thank you for backsliders coming in. I thank you that we'll not be comfortable, God. I thank you there will be no comfortableness in us, God. That your word will find us out and find us and reach where we are, God. That will cause us to grow, cause us to think, Father God. I decree and I declare, God, what you decide to do, you do it in the name of Jesus. And we give you glory and praise in Jesus' name, amen. 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 We're going to the word. Hallelujah. If you have it, if you will turn quickly, hallelujah, to 1 Corinthians. First. Amen. Let's get the offering out of the way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give unto the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Bless you, Father. As we give unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Who causes it to come back 30, 60, and 100 fold. Give and it shall be given back to you again. Press down, shake it together, running over. Will God cause men to give into our bosom? Amen. He will cause men, hallelujah, to bless us back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give you glory and praise. We thank you for those that are giving on Cash App. Hallelujah. We honor you, our Facebook family. We honor you. We bless you. We thank God for you. Hallelujah. We are one body. And you are part of us. And we love you. And we pray for you. When we see your name on there, I can't see you now. But hallelujah. But when I go back and look, we cover you. We pray for you. We love you. We are one body. And whatever your situation is, we are believing God for you. If you'll turn to 1 Chronicles, amen, the 28th chapter, hallelujah, verses 1 through 9. My text is coming out of verses 7, 8, and 9. Hallelujah. But I'm going to read down through the 7th. And like I said, you're going to get a little sermon here. We got another service. But I believe that God's going to speak to you today. And David says in the first verse, 1 Chronicles 28, in your reading, and David assembled all the princes of Israel, the princes of the tribes and the captains of the companies that ministered to the king by course, and the captains over the thousands and captains over the hundreds, and the stewards all over all the substance and possessions of the king and of his sons with the officers and with the mighty men and with all the valiant men unto Jerusalem. Now right here, David is on his deathbed. And David right now is calling everybody. We know that he was a mighty king. David has called everybody that had worked up under him. The men of war, he called all of the captains, whether they was over 1,000, whether they was over hundreds, or whether they was over 50, he called them. He called the mighty men of valor. He called all of those that worked in the temple. He called the treasure together. He called those that watched at the gate. Everyone, he called the priests. He called his everyone that was ministered to him in some way or another, even those that kept the finances, even those that was on his security team, he called all of them together. Then David said, the king stood up upon his feet. And I remember he is at a time, David is about to die. He has been sick. And at this particular time, he says unto his people, he called them all together and he come to give them a last charge before he transitioned. And he said, hear me, my brethren and my people. As for me, I have in my heart to build an house of rest for the ark of the covenant of the Lord and for the footstool of our God, and have made ready for the builders. He said, now, I have already picked out the material. I had everything ready to build God and house. I got everything ready. I bought all of the timber. I bought all of the nails. I bought everything that it takes. I bought the glass. I bought the carpet. Everything that it takes to build the house of the God. Now he's talking to the children of Israel who he was king over. He said, but I had all of this ready. He said, I was ready to build the house of God, for the ark of God, for God to have a footstool, somewhere to just prop his feet up on. I want you to hear me attentively. But God said unto me, thou shalt not build an house for my name, because thou hast been a man of war and hast shed many blood. But God told him, I don't want you to build me a house. But he did allow him to get all the material. That was the thing he was supposed to do. He did prepare everything that was needed, the chandeliers. You know, David, you know, when he built his house, and he built the best for him, but he built the best for the, he was going to build the best for the Lord. And so he said, but because you've been a man of war, because you was called to battle, because you shedded blood, I don't want you to build the temple. Howbeit, the Lord God of Israel chose me before the house of my father to be the king over Israel forever, for he have chosen Judah to be the ruler, and of the house of Judah, the house of my father, and among the sons of my father, he like me to be king over Israel. Right here he's testifying on his deathbed. He remember all of the things that God had done for him. And I'm trying to hurry, but hallelujah. But he's saying that when I was nobody, when I was tending to my father's sheep, God sent Samuel. He sent him down to pull me out of my father's house. My father's name was Jesse. But also before that, God had chosen out of my ancestors, my great, 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 great grandparents, all the way back to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob had 12 boys. One of those boys' names was Judah. Well, God chose Judah to be the head of all of the tribes. Judah meaning praise. God put them out front. Well, I come up out of my tribe. The rest of my lineage, I come from out of there. So he's testifying how that God had chose Judah. But after Judah, God chose his family line. He chose the family of Jesse. But out of the family of Jesse, out of 8 boys, he said, God chose me. He sent Samuel to chose me to be king over you, to be king over you, Israel. And David waited. Even though Saul was king at the time, he did not try to take his place before time. He waited on the Lord. And he said, and all my sons, he's talking about now his children. He said, out of all my sons, for the Lord have given me many sons. And I read, and he had about 19 children. And I have to go back and see if all of them were sons, but he had a whole lot of sons. And it says, he have chosen Solomon to be my son, to sit upon the throne of the kingdom of the Lord over Israel. And God did choose Solomon. I'm not going to go through the history of that, but he did choose Solomon after David to reign, even though another son tried to steal the kingdom from Solomon. But they heard about it, and God got away. I don't care what the enemy tried to do. God will keep you ahead of the enemy. He sent him down there. Bathsheba said, now, King David, didn't you choose Solomon to be reign over Israel? He said, what's McConnell, your other son, I think it was Absalom, trying to take over. But God set it up. Hallelujah. And anyway, it says, hallelujah. He said unto Solomon. Now he's talking to Solomon. I want you to take note that how that we should care about the things of the Lord. And I'm going to give you my topic in a minute because I'm going somewhere. And he said unto me, Solomon, thy son, he shall build thy house and my courts, for I have chosen him to be my son and I will be his father. And he's telling David, like he told him, you know, the mercy of God will be at your house forever. The keys of the kingdom will be at your house forever. And he said, I've chosen Solomon. And Solomon shall not only be your son, but be my son. Then somebody, God calls us into the family of God. And not only is you his father, but I'm going to be his father. Tell God thank you because he's our father. Come on and bless the Lord. He says, moreover, I will establish his kingdom forever. If he be consistent, now I want you to take note of that little bit of two-letter word, if. If, come on somebody. If he be constant to do my commandments and my judgments at this time. Now the same thing God said then, remember that the word of God is the same today, forevermore. He does not change. He is the same. And the same word that he gave David to give to his son, God is saying to us today. If, I want that to sink in, if we be constant to do the commandments of the Lord, not the commandments of Providence, not the commandments of Pastor Newsom, not the commandments of the evangelist, not the commandments of the musician, not the commandments of the deacons, but I said, if we continue and be constant means continually to do the commandments of the Lord. For I have, and he said, my commandments and my judgment as at this day. Say this day.
This day.
Don't let sink that out of your life. Continue this day. Now he says, that was the Lord speaking unto David, telling him, these are the conditions, and they apply to everybody. He told David that. He told David to tell Solomon that. He telling us that, and he telling you to tell your children that. If you walk in the commandments of the Lord, you will be blessed. You will be in the lineage and in the house of the Lord. But it's only, what's the key word?
If.
Come on, y'all got it. Okay, it says, hallelujah. It says, moreover, I will establish my kingdom with him. 8 verse, I'm sorry. Now, therefore, in the sight of all Israel, talking to those that he have led, talking to all of those that have worked with him, talking to all of those that was around him when he was king, that supported him in his ministry. He's called all of these men together. He's called all of his sons together. And he's saying, he's giving them a charge and giving Solomon, his son, a charge. He says, now, for in the sight of all Israel, the congregation of the Lord, and in the audience of our God. And he's saying, I'm talking to you in the presence of God. I acknowledge God in all of my ways. I just want to take time, O Israel. I just want to take time, O Providence. I just want to take time, O Facebook. I just want to take time, O YouTube. I just want to take time, O Instagram, to acknowledge the Lord our God. I just want to tell you, in the presence of all of the people, presence, oh God, of the world, of all 7 continents. I want to take time as David did. Hallelujah. To acknowledge our God and to keep and seek him. I want you to hold that word. Say, seek him.
Seek him.
He says, I want you to acknowledge him, keep and seek him for all the commandments of the Lord your God, that you may possess this good land and leave it. Glass is getting foggy. Hallelujah. Leave it for an inheritance for your children after you forever. Look at the promises of God if you keep the commandments of the Lord. And thou, Solomon, my son, talking unto Solomon, know thou that the God of thy father, say now you know the God of my father, you know the God of me. He says, I want you to serve him. That's what we need to be telling our children. That's what we need to be telling the next generation. You need to serve God. Your children ought to know who your God is. They ought to know who you serve. They ought to see you serving somebody. You can't tell them to serve the Lord unless you serve them. But David served the Lord. He built, he stayed in the house of the Lord. And he served God all the days of his life. Even on his deathbed, he is concerned about the house of God. So he's putting some things in order on his deathbed. Come on, somebody. Somebody ain't got that tenacity and they ain't on their deathbed. They ain't even trying to serve God on the deathbed. But God is speaking at the point, David is speaking at the point of death. And it says that, he says, I want you to seek the Lord and serve him. Hallelujah. He says that ye may possess all of the good land that will be left to you. And thou, Solomon my son, know thou that God of thy father, and serve him with a perfect heart and with a willing mind. For the Lord searcheth all hearts and understand all the imagination of the thoughts. If thou seek him, he will be found of thee. But if thou forsake him, he will cast thee off forever. My texts come out of 7, 8, and 9, which says, hallelujah, it's high time to seek the Lord. You see that in the 7th, 8th, 9th verse, you see David admonishing the people, admonishing his son to seek the Lord. And I don't know of a better day and time it is for us to seek the Lord. When I thought about seeking the Lord, it's time, it's high time to seek the Lord. I thought about time. When we think about time, we think about something that has occurred. We think about, I'm giving you some watchwords. I want you to pay attention because God's going to drop some things in your spirit. Time is a specific period. There is an appointed time. It is a fixed moment. It is a particular minute or hour. Seeking the Lord, he told him. He said, seek the Lord with all of your heart and your mind. Keep it on the Lord. When you go before the Lord and to serve him, he says that your heart and your mind have to be engaged. Your mind is not engaged if your heart ain't engaged. And your heart ain't engaged if your mind ain't engaged. The reason why he says that, and the reason why he said that you must seek the Lord, meaning that you must set aside a particular time. You must set aside a specific period. You must set aside an appointed time. You must set aside a fixed time. You must set aside a particular moment. What it's saying is that you must be intentional. Tell somebody intentional. It means that your mind got to be purposeful on seeking the Lord, meaning that you got to set aside some time out of your day, out of your schedule, out of your work life, out of your family life, out of your church life. You got to set aside some time to seek the Lord. It means that you got to put some time aside where you're going to spend time with the Lord. And the reason why I say that, he already told us, if we're going to seek the Lord, he told us first thing in the morning, he told us in Matthew 6:33, but seek ye first. God got to be first in your life. You got to put God first. If you spend the first day, the first hour, the first minute, get an appointed time, get a fixed moment. When you get up, first thing in the morning, set aside that time to seek the Lord. Put him first. The reason why he said it's high time to seek the Lord. How mean above. High mean over everything else. High means that it's on top. Well, if you seek God first, that means he at the beginning of your day. It means that he is on top of everything else. It means that he's high above everything else. High above. If you put God first, you put him over everything else. Put him over your family problems. Put him over your troubles. Come on, somebody. Put him first. He says that seek him first. Not only seek him, but his kingdom. Seek his righteousness. Then he tells us, and seek me and you shall find me when you search for me with all of your heart. That's in Jeremiah 29:13. He says, come with your heart involved. You got to come before me. You can't come heartless. You got to let it be earnest. You got to let it be heartfelt. Come on, God know when you sincere. You got to come before me in spirit and in truth. I know when you're coming to me and your heart is not right. When you're coming before me and you haven't come with a pure heart, you haven't come before me with an earnest request. He's saying that you got to put it all. Come on, somebody. You got to come before me praying with every fiber of your being. It ought to be heartfelt. It ought to be some tears rolling sometimes. It ought to be sometimes where you can't say anything but you're crying. With compassion, sincerity. If you don't feel his presence when you're seeking him, and you don't sense him, and he seems to be distant, you know, we used to play a little game called hide and seek. You know, God do a little hiding sometimes to see if you're really sincere about seeking him. Sometimes you get in his presence, and because you really hadn't planned on spending but 5 or 10 minutes in his presence, he said, I'm going to hide a little bit. I'm going to see how long they're going to take and really seek me. But you ought to seek God until his presence shows up. You ought to seek God till love shows up. You ought to seek God till love shows up. Till the peace of God shows up. I don't care how distant he feels. Even if he is hiding, God is saying, I want to see how long you're going to see me. I'm going to see if you're going to really seek to see my face. When I looked up, it says, seeking God's face. The Hebrew word meant for seek me, the face of God. God said, you ought to get all up in my face. If you seek me long enough, you can get in my presence. If you seek me long enough. Hallelujah. It gets up close. And personal. God get all up in your business. Hallelujah. And he can get all up. You can get in his business. He'll tell you what's on his mind. When you engage your heart and your mind to the will of God. Hallelujah. He'll tell you. Hallelujah. So he said, get close. He says in Psalms 145:18, the Lord is near, close to all them who call on him. In truth. They that seek me must seek me and worship me in spirit and truth. Psalm 17:1. Hear the right, O Lord, attend unto my cry, give ear to my prayer, that thou goest not out of unfringed lips. I'm gonna read these scriptures because I'm gonna give you something. The Lord is with you while you be with him. And if you seek him, he will be found of you. But if you forsake him, he will forsake you. 2 Chronicles 15:2 part B. That comes out of our text. He says, seek you the Lord while he may be found. Call ye upon him while he is near. Isaiah 55:6 says, For thus said the Lord, excuse me. Hallelujah. Y'all know I'm just getting over taking an antibiotic, okay? Pray for me, church. Hallelujah. For thus said the Lord unto the house of Israel, seek ye me and ye shall live. Amos 5:8 says, the Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. Seek the Lord and his strength and his presence continually. Psalms 105:5. 1 Chronicles 16:11. Seek the Lord and his strength and his presence continually. Proverbs 8:17. I love those that love me, and those that seek me diligently find me. Psalms 34 and 10. The young lions suffer lack and hunger, but those that seek the Lord lack no good thing. I want to tell you in Jeremiah 29, 12 and 14. Then you shall call upon me and come and pray to me, and I will hear you, and you will seek me and find me when you search for me with all your heart. Remember, your heart got to be engaged. I will be found of you, declares, says the Lord, and I will restore you the fortunes and gather you from all nations and all the places where I have thrown you, declares the Lord, and I will bring you back to the place from which ye shall be in exile. I want to give you a couple of watchwords that have came up out of this text. I want to tell you that the watchwords is you got to be intentional. I want to tell you that God said you got to have a specific time. You got to have an appointed time. You got to have a fixed moment. You got to have a particular hour or a minute to get up close, get up personal, get face to face with God. I also want to tell you that when you go to God on this side, I want to tell you the benefits that come out on the other side. When you set your mind and your heart on God, this is what you got to do. You got to set your own mind. We know that in Colossians it tells us, first thing in the morning, to set your mind on things above. Where is God at? Above. We know that Jesus went back up and he's sitting at the right hand of the Father. Above every principality, every demonic mount and power. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know what I know what I'm talking about. But hallelujah. He has set us above. Jesus has set above. And he wants us to set our mind and our affections on things above. He wants us to seek his kingdom. When we are seeking God, he already told us in the scripture what to seek. He said, seek my kingdom. Seek my righteousness. He said, I want you to search for me. He said, I want you to come to me. I'm giving you watchwords. Come on, somebody. Tell somebody I'm taking in the watchwords. Come on, somebody. God is speaking to me. God is downloading me. God is giving me a watchword. God is giving me a prophetic word. I'm coming to the secret chamber. God is telling me how to get into the secret place of the Most High God. He said, this is what you got to do. You got to come. With it being hard there, you got to come and it's got to be nervous. You got to come with some compassion. You got to come seeking my strength. You got to come seeking my presence. You got to come with some love in your heart. You got to come with a diligent attitude. You got to come with a diligent mind. You got to come calling on the Lord. You got to come calling on my name. You got to come with me in mind. You got to pray to me. You got to call out to me. You got to do it with everything that's within you. I told you to serve me with all of your heart, with all of your mind, with all of your soul. I want everything in danger when you begin to see me. Watch words. Tell somebody I got it. Watchwords. I'm going to wrap it up because I know we got a 3 o'clock service. Want to give you the rest of your watchwords. When you engage like God says, here are the benefits. He said you'll find me. You'll be in my presence. You'll be face to face with love. You'll be face to face with peace. You'll be face to face with joy. He said there'll be no more distance, but you will be up closer. You'll be near. I told you if you draw nigh to me, I'll draw nigh to you. I'll be near unto you. The very word in your mouth, I'll be as close as the word in your mouth. When you open up your mouth, I put the word of faith in your mouth. He said if you will just attend to me, I'll attend unto you. I'll give you my ear. Those words will come from unfriend's lips. Hallelujah. They will be satisfied lips. They will be pure lips. They will be pure words. For I'll sanctify you in my presence. I'll cleanse you in my presence. I'll heal you in my presence. I'll lift you up in my presence. I'll regulate your mind in my presence. These are the benefits that you do the other part. This is what you're going to come out with. I'll be with you just like you were with me. You will find you will find me. Not only that, you shall live and shall not die. I speak life into you. I bring life into you. In my presence, you'll find life forevermore. I will preserve you from evil. I will preserve you from the wicked one. These are the benefits of being in the presence of the Lord, of seeking the Lord. You will find God. Hallelujah. He says, if you just come, he said, you will find me. He said, there'll be no lack. He said, the young lions, they lack itself of hunger. But he said, those that seek me will lack no good thing. You won't have any lack. You won't experience lack. If you get in the presence of the Lord, God is calling us. He says, it's high time. I need you to put it above everything else. I need you to put it above CNN. I need you to put it above MSNBC. I need you to put it above Channel 2. I don't know where you're getting your news from, but I come to give you the good news. The gospel is the good news. I come to give you the news of the day. I come to tell you, you got benefits. There's no fear attached to this word. When you turn on the TV, there's fear attached to that word. But God said, if you seek me, and I take away your fear, you can come out with a benefit. You don't have to have no fear. He said, I'll restore unto you. It's a lot of people lost a lot of things. But in that last scripture we read, he said, I'll restore you. I'll restore those jobs. But you've got to come and seek the Lord. These are benefits. God is in the spirit of restoration. He come to restore lives. He come to restore homes. He come to restore marriages. He come to restore broken relationships. He come to restore your life. He come to restore that broken life. He come to speak to the wounded places. God speaks life unto you. If you'll search for him with all of your heart, if you'll cry out Facebook, if you'll cry out those that are watching, if you'll cry out to God, if you just call him Jesus, if you just call his name, he will show up. He said, if you call me, I'll come. I'll forgive you. I'll forgive you out of all of your trials. I'll forgive you out of all of your troubles. Sermon, but God gave you a lot of nuggets. He gave you what's on his heart. He gave you what was on his mind. And he said above everything that you're going through,
yes,
you're going to need him.
Thank you.
Let me give you this last scripture he told me to give you. And I'm going to pray for us. Tell somebody, say us. Let's get an agreement for us. In this last scripture, come out of Amos. Hallelujah. This is why God is telling us to seek him. Now, he said the days are coming, declares the sovereign Lord, when I will send a famine through the land. How many see the famine in the land? How many see the shortages in the land? This is in Amos 8 and 11. Hear me closely. God is speaking. Don't want you to see me at all. I want you to hear the Spirit. So what I'm telling you now, God has gave you, I'm speaking prophetically to you, that it is high time above everything else. Tell somebody, above everything,
everything
else, to seek the Lord. He already told you, you should set aside a certain moment, a certain hour,
yes,
a certain week,
yes,
and I'm looking because God is talking to us. Hear the word of the Lord. What you gonna do when there's nobody to bring you the word? Remember, from Malachi to Matthew, almost 400 years, no word was given, not a word. Can you imagine what it's like? Now you're going to want the word. When it come a time when they try to take things from you, don't want you to have the word. But you spend time seeking God now. While the word is still going forth, while we can still come to the house of the Lord, we may can't join hands like we used to, but we can get on the telephone line. We can get on the Facebook. Any kind of way you can seek the word of the Lord. God is saying, seek me. I want you to spend time seeking me. And then he said, I want you to do it daily. I don't just want you to come to me on Sunday. I don't want you to just come to me on Wednesday. But I want you to serve me with all of your heart. I want you to serve me with all of your mind. That means daily you should come before me. Daily have I renewed my benefits. Daily do I give you mercy. Daily do I give you strength. I told you to come to me daily and seek the Lord. So it is high time to seek the Lord above anything else, above anything that you go through, above your sickness, above your trials, above your tribulations, above anything that you go through. God has given you watchwords today. And we'll take those watchwords and we'll do what God said. We'll experience the benefits of those watchwords. watchwords on the other side. God will be up close, and personal. Hallelujah. I appeal unto you, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. I appeal unto you, to the unsaved, to the saved, to the backslider. Hallelujah. To those who don't know anything about God, God is calling you to seek him right where you are. He loves you. And I say to you that want to be saved, all you have to do is quote Romans 10, 9, and 10. He says that if you would confess with your mouth and believe in your heart, and that if you would just accept the Lord Jesus Christ, that the word is nigh thee, even in thy mouth, the very word of faith that I just preached, that's how close God is to you. He's up close and personal. He's just one word away. All you got to do is open up your mouth and ask God to come, Lord. Deliver me, God. Help me, God. Set me free. And that's what he wanted to do. So I appeal to you, and you just ask God in your own way. Ask God to help you. Ask God to deliver you. God, help me to set aside that time to spend with you. Hallelujah. So as we accept those that are dealing with coming to the Lord, it's just this simple. Say, Father, I ask you to forgive me of my sins. I do believe that Jesus died.
I believe that Jesus died.
And he rose again.
And he rose again.
And I accept him.
And I accept him.
Into my heart.
Into my heart.
As my Lord and Savior.
As my Lord and Savior.
Now we pray for you and we accept you into the body of Christ.
Yes.
We are one family, a household of faith. You can reach out to Pastor Newsom. Tag him. He's Pastor Marshall Newsom. We're here to help you any way we can. And we accept all of you. We say, God bless you. We love you. Remember the watchwords. It is high time to seek the Lord. And then put your heart and your mind in it. We love you. We love you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.